Yes? Okay. So good afternoon and welcome everyone. Today's talk is on the law of attraction, and my name is Parvez Daruwala. I've given a number of talks here at the Help Library, and I'm going to be speaking on the law of attraction. So what is the law of attraction? Any of you have heard of it? Please feel free to share.
Whatever you send in this universe comes back to you.
Okay. So send and you said comes back. So whatever you send comes back to you. Okay? All right, that's interesting. That's something what we're going to be talking more of. Any other thoughts?
There is an abundance in the nature. You create your frequency and attract.
Fine. So, as Mr. Suresh says, there's an abundance in nature, and you can create that abundance in your own life and attract it. And if you actually see, that is very true. How many of us have looked at the sky in the night? We have, right? All of us have sometime or the other. And when we look up, especially when there are not many earth lights down, it's, you go to a small place, you see so many stars. How many stars are there in the universe? Trillions and trillions and trillions. There's an abundance of stars, abundance of planets, abundance of galaxies, right? If you go to the beach, there's abundance of sand, there's abundance of water, lots of trees, though of course people are cutting down trees, which is really unfortunate. Still, there are millions and millions of trees on the planet. And how many people are there on the planet? Huge abundance of people, 7 billion plus, that's 700 crore. So isn't that quite an abundance, right? So there is abundance all around us, in the universe, on the planet. We just need to create a mindset of abundance and then attract it to us. So that's what we are going to be talking about today, which is the law of attraction, which simply means attracting to you what you'd like to have in your life. And how do we attract? How do we attract these things? Through our thoughts and feelings or emotions, which we are going to be calling or terming as your vibration. For the purpose of the law of attraction, we'll call this the vibration. What do we mean by vibration? Wonderful. Okay, it's an energy which you send out, which reaches the others, which emits all around you. Right? So I'm sure each one of you have heard of this thing called an aura or chakras, right? You have all heard of it? So you have an aura which vibrates your energy out. You have chakras which are made of energy and which vibrate out in turn. They vibrate towards other energy beings and in turn attract of similar nature. So let's just look at what we really mean by this. Can you all read this? Can you read it loudly?
It's a universal law which states that you create your life with your habitual thoughts. Therefore, the quality of your thoughts determine the quality of your life.
Yeah, wonderful. Thank you. Somebody else? Would you like to read the next bit from here? Okay.
You attract into your life.
I have to start on this.
Yes.
You attract into your life what you give focus to with your thoughts and feelings, your vibrations. Since you are doing your own thinking, you have the power to attract what you desire. Thus, begin to believe that you are a powerful being.
Okay, so let's revisit this. It's a universal law. By law here, we don't mean a law which is passed in any parliament, but it's a law of the universe, the law of attraction. Somebody decided to call these principles as the law of attraction since more than a century, and that's what we have been terming it as. But this law, if we may use the term law, has been existence ever since the universe has been created. Especially with conscious beings like humans, the law of attraction has been present. So what does it state? You create your life with your habitual thoughts. So I'd like you all to reflect a little on your own lives right now and try and understand how whatever's happened in your life, somewhere along you have thought a lot about some of those things and those things happened in your life. Right? So things like health, things like wealth, things like career, things like relationships. We often think on a particular track about these things. And when we keep thinking regularly on a similar track, that starts manifesting in our lives. Therefore, the quality of your thoughts determines the quality of your life. Right? So if we are in agreement that your thoughts create the things in your life, then the quality of your thoughts will create the quality of your life. Right? So are we all in sync up till now? Yes? Wonderful. So you attract into your life what you give focus to with your thoughts and your feelings. You attract in your life what you keep giving focus to. This is a very important word over here. Right? Focus. When we were all small in school, I'm sure most of us must have done that experiment with a magnifying glass. You put a paper beneath it, then beam the sun rays, and then it flares into fire. Right? So that's the power of focus. Right? So as you focus more and more on a particular thing, it can start turning into the way your life as per the thoughts you have been having. And along with the thoughts, a very important thing which we must realize is feelings. So it's not only your thoughts, it's your thoughts plus feelings. And this is what we call as vibration. This is what you're vibrating. So your aura actually is composed of your thoughts and feelings, which in other words, we also call as energy, right? These days, everybody keeps talking energy, 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 energy. Everything is energy, right? So those of us who are kind of inclined towards, say, some metaphysics, some spirituality, some esoteric thinking, there's a lot of talk of energy. Energy is everything. We say energy is in everything. Everything is composed of energy. So the energy you emit, the energy which you create, you send out through your thoughts and feelings, has the power to attract to you based on the quality of that thought. Okay? Therefore, since you're doing your own thinking, you have the power to attract what you desire. Right? And therefore, it's important for us to believe that we are a powerful creator. A creator of our own lives. So, here are three principles of the law of attraction. What are these?
Thoughts become things.
Simple, we just spoke of that. So as you keep thinking of something in a very focused manner, you create that thing in your life. Next.
What you focus on grows.
So what you focus on grows. Therefore, focusing is important, right? And?
Similarities of vibration attract
each other.
Each other. Like attracts like.
Yeah. So what does this mean? So if you're having, yes. Right. So if you have two similar people with similar kind of thinking, they will have a gelling between them. You say, I get good vibes from this person. You resonate with them. On the other hand, there are times you must have noticed there are some people, you just come into contact with them and something kind of puts you off. You feel, oh, I didn't get good vibes from that person. You know, I felt uncomfortable with that person. So there is something within the energy of the person, that inner feeling, which in again other words we are calling as vibration. Therefore it is important for us to understand that what you are vibrating creates your daily experiences and your life onwards. Okay? Yes, please.
First sentence of thoughts become things.
Yeah.
What is the principle there? What is the process like? How the thoughts become things?
Okay,
what is
so
the underlying principle?
The underlying principle is this: what you focus on grows. So, for example, can you think of something which you have thought about a lot? You keep giving it focus, and then you find your life becoming of that nature. Think about it. I'm sure there must be many examples. In fact, our whole life is based on what we have thought about. The thing we have to realize over here is that very often we say, okay, oh, but my life is not doing well. I'm not happy in my life. I'm not healthy. I'm not wealthy. I don't have great relationships. The underlying thing is your thoughts have been of that nature, and therefore you're not happy, healthy, wealthy, or having the best of relationships. Okay? So are you clear now? Sure? Okay? Okay. So let me give you an example. There was a time when I was studying in college. I'm sure most of us have been studying in college. And I was not very academic in that sense, quite happy-go-lucky. But there was this one particular year in which I wanted to get first class. You know, up till then I'd never really bothered. I said, only thing criterion was pass on hai. 35% mil gaya, theek hai, happy. And trust me, I used to keep getting those kind of percentages only, 45, 50, 55, and I'm happy. Theek hai, pass ho gaya na, next class mein jayega, whatever. But there was this one phase where I was studying something. I was doing my master's in social work, and I don't know why, I just wanted to get a first class in that. So exams over, everything done. Then I was not sure, some papers didn't go so well. But I kept thinking, I have to get first class, I have to get first class, I have to get first class. Of course, before I knew all of this kind of stuff, so the way one would focus in those days was through what we call as prayer. Prayer to Bhagwan, right? To God. But that is also focusing your thoughts, right? And I was so happy when I got 65 point some percentage. But I got my first class. 65% was the first class for a Master of Social Work. Generally, it used to be, I think, 60%. But because this is a master's, I think it was 65%. So that's one example where the thoughts became things. What was the thing over here? A percentage which I was looking for. Similarly, I wanted a job in a particular organization to which I had applied. And I was not very sure I could get it. But I kept thinking, okay, yes, and once again, prayers. You know, in those days, it's prayers that one focused a lot on. I ended up getting a job in that organization. Similarly, a few years later, I wanted to become a teacher of Reiki. I'd learned Reiki all three levels. And I said, okay, fine. But then I found it all very fascinating. So I kept thinking of that, focusing on that. And yes, one day I became a Reiki teacher and so on. So the point is, what you keep focusing on will materialize. The word we use is results. Okay, good. I like that word. I'll use that over here. Results. Right? We also use the word manifestation. So I'm sure you have heard of that. So a lot of people, especially in terms like this, use the word manifestation. What do you manifest in your life? Okay. So energy. We spoke of energy some time back, right? So everything is composed of energy, including our own cells. How are we composed of energy? Those of us who work with energy, like I remember last time you had spoken to me of polarity theory, right? So it is all about the energy which we have within us, the atoms, the cells, the molecules, the biological cells. It's all vibrating, vibrating. And that's how also we create our vibration. So everything in that sense is energy. This computer, this television is all working on energy, the energy of electricity. The recording she's doing is again through the energy, right? So I'm speaking through some energy which is flowing through me. You are listening to me through some energy within you. So in that sense, everything is composed of energy. Now, one of the other principles of energy is that energy goes where your attention goes. Similar to what you focus on through your thoughts and feelings, what you focus on becomes a thing. Thoughts are therefore energy too. Right? So the other way to explain to you how thoughts become things is because thoughts are also energy. Right? Okay, let's do one small little exercise. Some of you may be familiar with it. But how do we kind of create our own energies? Right? So I'd like you all to rub your palms together. Right? Rub them for a few minutes till you start feeling warm. You'll start feeling some tingling, some warmth. Are you feeling that? Yes, wonderful. Now slowly, slowly move your palms away and bring them together like this. Keep doing this. And keep your mental focus in between your two palms. So mentally, keep your focus between your palms and figure out what you are experiencing there. Is there something you can experience?
Yes.
What is that?
Some kind of attraction.
Ah, some kind of attraction going on.
Something is there
you feel. Right? But you can't see it.
Yeah.
Right? But there is some kind of magnetism kind of thing, as you said, attraction happening. So that is the energy which you have created now through your palms. Okay, rubbing the palms and then just doing this and this. Now, wait, keep doing this. Okay, because you have created a ball of energy. So let's assume you have created a ball of energy. Right? Now, use your imagination and give that ball of energy a color. So some of you may want to see it as a golden color ball. Some of you may want to see it as a pink ball or a green ball, whatever color, violet. Right? Or just let any color flow. So any particular color may just drop in into your mind. When that happens, just be aware of that and put one particular thought into it of something you'd like to have, something you'd like to attract in your life. So just put one thought into that ball of energy you have created now. And do it in the past sense, past tense, as if it has already happened. So, a very simple thing, for example, I have a pleasant, convenient journey back home. It's a very simple thought right now. But just keep that kind of thought. That's just an example. You can choose your own thoughts or wishes. Push that into the ball of light. Rather, you don't have to push. You just imagine you're putting it into the ball of light. Now, gently bring your hands under the ball of light. Yeah, put your hands under the ball of light, so you're covering it in both hands, and gently just tip it on top of your head, and just visualize it kind of goes through you, and that's it. Yeah, right? So it's gone now into your own energy bubble, or your own energy of your body, your aura, and it will start working towards getting manifested. It's a very simple exercise, but it's pretty good. So keep working with that. So this is about using energy, energy ball exercise. Are we clear?
Yes.
Right? Right. Now we looked at earlier spoke of feelings also. So let's look at the role of feelings in this whole process. Would you be able to read? Okay. Never mind. Can you read?
Not yeah. Just thoughts, but feelings are important to create what you desire. Feelings turbocharge the thoughts with their emotional content. To manifest or create something, get into the feeling of how you will feel when that desire is attained. Feelings are energy too.
Okay, so let's relook at each of this. So not only thoughts, but your feelings are very important to create what you desire. So very often we say that, okay, think positive, think positive, think positive. Very true. But along with that, you also need to have similar feelings. So if you're thinking positive, but you're not feeling good, yeah, that will not work out. So feelings are extremely, extremely important. Your emotions are very important. Anybody over here has never experienced any feelings or emotions? Everyone has, right? So none of us have gone through life without experiencing any feelings. That's what differentiates us maybe from the other creatures on the planet. And in fact, even animals have feelings. Research has shown plants have feelings. Jagdish Chandra Bose, who was one of our greatest scientists, actually did experiments to show that plants have feelings. Those experiments were later on done in Western laboratories and have been validated. Okay? So feelings are everywhere. They are part of what you call as your vibration or your energy makeup. So add feelings to your thoughts. Now, what kind of feelings? Feelings that make you feel good. It's common sense, right? So when you want to create something, when you want to create things in your life, please see that first of all, you are in a feeling where you're feeling good. If you want to manifest say a good job, okay, and you're in a job which is not good right now, for example, right, you're unhappy in your current job and you want to create a good job, and you say, okay, I'll get a good job, but at the back of your mind you're thinking all the time and you're feeling bad about the bad job you have, you're going to be blocking the good job coming into your life. So this is the role of feelings. So it's not just thoughts, it's also feelings, and together they create what we call as a vibration, which, as I said earlier, is part of your aura or your energy field. Right? So what's next? So feelings turbocharge the thoughts with the emotional content, which means they give it much more power. To manifest or create something, get into the feeling of how you will feel when that desire is attained. So let's say you decide that next month you want to have something coming to you, right? And like each one of you think of something small, maybe, because it may be too much to kind of create something too big right now if you're not in that mode. So think of something you'd like to attain next month. Actually do that right now. And then get into feeling how you would feel, how happy you'd feel, how good you'd feel, how excited you would feel when you receive that thing. So you will feel happy when you get what you want next month. But that feeling you need to feel right now when you are thinking of getting that. Is this clear? As if you've already got it. Absolutely. Understood, everyone? So when you create that feeling, I have got what I want, when you create that feeling, not just the thought, but when you have the feeling that, yes, I have got what I want now, creating that feeling now, you see, you're creating that vibration. And that vibration is then attracting to you that particular thing. Like we said, thoughts become things. So it's very important to have the similar feelings which you are going to have when you get the thing which you are looking for. Feelings are energy too. Okay, now this is very important, clarity. You know, it may not seem so important, but it's very important, clarity about what you wish to have. Very often we say, okay, so I know all of this, you know, I know if I think positively, I'll get positive things. If I think negatively, I'll get negative things. I know all of this. But the point is, my life is still not doing well. Yeah? The reason is because it is not doing well because we are actually not very clear on what we want our life to be like.
Very vague
in your thinking.
Very clear about
not
yes.
Specific.
We are not being specific. Or, which is a very big or over here, is you're focusing on what you do not want. And because the law of attraction works whichever way you think, you end up getting what you do not want. So if you're constantly thinking of what you do not wish to have in your life, but you're constantly thinking of that, then that's what keeps coming into your life, because those are the kind of thoughts you're magnetizing to you. And along with those thoughts, you definitely are giving out feelings of not being happy. Yes? Are you all getting this? So it's important that you be very clear of what you want. So a good idea is to ask yourself the question, so what is it that I really want? Or what is it that I really desire in my life? Keep asking yourself, what is it that I desire? It's never too late, whatever our age is, it's never too late to have a life of happiness, joy, health, fun, etc. So always ask yourself, so what is it that I really desire? What is it that I wish to have? So be clear. Focus more on what you wish to be, do or have, rather than on what you do not wish to have. But as I said, many of us, and very often inadvertently, without knowing, without realizing, our focus is on what we do not wish to have in life. So think of the time. Let's say you're having a challenging relationship with someone close in your family, right? You go to work, but you're thinking of the problem at home. You go out with friends, but at the back of your mind, you're thinking of the fight you had with your wife or husband, right? Or the challenges your teenage children are posing to you. So all the time, you're thinking of those things which you don't really wish to have in your life. But that is the vibration which you are creating and you're offering to the universe. And so the universe says, okay, to aap ye soch rahe ho har waqt, theek hai, yehi le lo. So like somebody said, God is always saying Tathastu. Amen. Every time God is only saying Amen, Amen, Amen. So if you're thinking of good, yeah, you're going to get good from Him. If you're thinking not so good, still it is Tathastu. So He's given us the responsibility of creating our own life. So this law of attraction shows us this is how we can create a life which we desire to have. Okay? Therefore, be clear on what you wish to have and not on what you don't wish to have. Do not focus on what you do not wish to have. So often inadvertently, people keep thinking, focusing on what they do not wish to have or do, and they give it more energy. And then that is what shows up in their lives. Right? So be aware of what you wish to have in your life. Clarity, therefore, is very important. One of the ways to start getting more clarity is write. You know, they say if you make your goals and you write your goals, you're giving energy to your goals, and most likely your goals will manifest because you're writing them down. Okay? So this has been proved by some research done in some lab somewhere here and there, that people who write down their goals generally end up receiving the goals the way they wished. Okay? So write it down. If you're not very sure what you want, write it still down. The process of writing will bring you more clarity. So sometimes we are more clear of what we don't wish to have in life. For example, I don't want all this noise around me. I don't want all these crowds around me. I don't want people shouting and screaming around me. So what am I saying? I don't want this, I don't want this, I don't want this. So I'm clear on what I don't want. But what is it that I really want? You know? So if I were to look at that by writing it down, it will give me an idea that, okay, so what I really want is, I want more peace in my life. And then I write, I desire peace. Right? Instead of saying, I don't want noise and I don't want crowds and I don't want XYZ. So be clear. And the way to be clear is to make what may also be called as a contrast list. So draw up a list of the contrast of what you don't want, and then the opposite of that is which is you do wish to have. Okay, so the law of attraction and vibrations. Would somebody read?
The law of attraction responds to whatever vibration you are emitting. It responds to your vibration. It gives you positive or negative results based on whether your vibrations are positive or negative. Your vibrations are the energy you are emitting, composed of the quality of your thoughts and emotions, feelings. Learn to discern the quality of your vibrations by understanding your feelings, emotions. Therefore, focus more of what you desire rather than what you do not desire.
Yes, so I think while discussing, talking, we have more or less discussed these things, right? So the law of attraction responds to the vibrations you are emitting. It gives you positive or negative results based on whether you're thinking positively or you're thinking of negative things. So as I just said earlier, if you think more of what you don't want in life, you end up getting what you don't want. And then you say, nay, all this is bunkum. All this law of attraction thing doesn't work because I'm still unhappy in my life. I'm still suffering. I still don't have enough money. I still don't have peace. I still don't have harmony. But the point is, that's exactly what you have been thinking of all the time. And that's exactly what the universe is giving to you through the law of attraction. So thoughts, energy you are emitting, composed of the quality of your thoughts and emotions and feelings. Learn to discern the quality of your vibrations by understanding your feelings and emotions. So what is the kind of vibration you are giving out? You have to understand that based on the kind of feelings you are having. Sometimes people find it difficult to actually pinpoint their thoughts, right? So, but feelings is something you are aware of. So when you are angry, for example, are you aware that right now I am angry?
Yes.
You are aware, right? Is waqt mujhe bahut gussa aa raha hai. I am angry. Or when you are sad, you know you are sad. Or when you are happy, you know you are happy. You feel happy. You feel joyous. So we know what we are feeling. What we need to do is realize that whenever we are going through those feelings which don't make you feel good, which don't make you feel good, and deliberately start shifting your feelings to having thoughts which make you feel good. Okay? Because very often your feelings arise from your thoughts. So if I'm having...
Replace your negative thoughts.
Yes. Yes. And that's when you will have good feelings. So the whole idea or the whole thing which I'd like you to understand is the importance of feelings in this whole picture here. Thoughts are very important, right? But thoughts lead to feelings, and feelings lead to the vibrations, which in turn lead to the attraction factor. So be aware of the feelings you have. Let's do one small quick exercise right now, right? Nothing you have to do except close your eyes for a few seconds, everyone. Please close your eyes for a few seconds and just become aware of what you're feeling right now. What are you feeling right now? Just become aware of that, each one of you. Okay, great. I think that was enough time. So can I have each one of you to share with me what you felt? Let's begin with the lady first. Ladies first. Very?
Happy.
Happy. Okay. What were you feeling?
Peaceful.
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 Calm. Peaceful. Okay? And I'm feeling nice and happy and excited and energized, as I feel every time I'm standing over here or whenever I have a talk to give. Right? So it becomes easy for us to know what we are feeling. Right? So that's important. Be aware of your feelings, and especially when you want to create something in your life, immediately ask yourself, am I emitting positive or happy vibrations or good vibrations? Only then start using the thoughts in the direction in which you want to create what you wish to create. Clear? So feelings, important. How do you feel good? Because there are times when we don't feel good, right? So if you just sit and pause, sit in a quiet place, and you want to create good feelings, well, one simple thing is go back to sometime in your past when you actually felt good. Right? So once again, let's do a quick exercise. Everyone just close your eyes once again. And just take your memory or allow your memory to take you to a time when you felt nice. When you felt good, when you felt happy, when you felt joyous and excited. Think back to those times. And actually get into those feelings. Feel those things. When you felt happy, when you felt excited, when you felt enthusiastic, joyous, all of that. Just feel that. Think of that moment. Everybody's there right now? Just nod your heads. Yes. Okay. Very good. Just be in that space. Please once again close your eyes and continue to be with that feeling. And we are going to do, I'll just share with you one very quick exercise from NLP, which is, we'll anchor it. It's called anchoring. Don't worry what it means. Now, just create with your hands some kind of a small gesture to remind you of that. Yeah, for example, Mr. Sirish has created the Gyana Mudra. Okay, you can do whatever you like. So for example, somebody may want to put the hands on the heart, or somebody can just make a fist, or touch your shoulder, right? So when you have this feeling of feeling nice and happy, create something with your hand which at another point in time will remind you of this great feeling. Clear, everyone? So everyone has created an anchor. We call this an anchor. Everyone has created an anchor? Yes? Wonderful. So even when you're not in this class, when you're out, when you're somewhere else and you want to experience feeling good, just create that anchor, close your eyes, do a little deep breathing, bring your focus on the anchor you're creating, and you'll start getting into the feeling of feeling good. Okay? So feeling good is thus an important element of law of attraction and the vibrations. So focus more on what you desire rather than what you do not desire. We discussed that earlier. Okay. Now, this is something called the emotional guidance system, where I just spoke of being aware of the kind of feelings or emotions you have. Your emotions can be used as a guidance system for you to understand what is going on inside you, or what are the kind of vibrations you are sharing or emitting out. Now, there are books written by a couple of authors called Abraham Hicks. So Abrahams were these entities who have dictated these books to a lady called Esther and her husband Jerry, who used to write it down. So it's like, let's not make it very complicated, but let's say the author of this are Abraham Hicks. So I'm just giving credit where it has to go. And they have listed down the emotional guidance systems into 22 emotions, ranging from 1 to 22. Right on top of the list, okay, is joy, knowledge, empowerment, freedom, love, appreciation, and gratitude. When you're vibrating at these, you're at the highest vibration level available to mankind. Okay? So joy, appreciation, knowledge, empowerment, love, gratitude. That's the highest you can reach with your emotions. Next, you have passion. So passion to do something, passion to be something. When you say passion, you know, when we say passion, I can immediately think of somebody like Shah Rukh Khan or Sachin Tendulkar or people like that, or even Narendra Modi, right? So these are people with a lot of passion.
Passion is on the top. That is why they say you can achieve anything if you have a burning desire.
Actually.
So that is passion.
Yes. Yeah? Which quickly is followed by enthusiasm, happiness, and eagerness. Next on the level is positive expectation or beliefs. Right? There are subtle differences between these. There's optimism then hopefulness, then contentment. Okay, dictated by entities called Abrahams.
What is the title?
They have written various books. This particular thing, the emotional guidance system, comes from a book called Ask and It Is Given. You have read it? Yes, it's a very nice book, Ask and It Is Given. And in the Bible, it is said, ask and you shall receive. Okay? So, it's a nice book, and today with books available any and everywhere, you can definitely get a copy. You can even get it. Abraham Hicks. Or you can write Jerry and Hester Hicks. Jerry and Esther Hicks. H-I-C-K-S. But normally they are referred to as Abraham Hicks. Okay? So we have contentment. And then on the, as you keep going down the scale, you have boredom. Now you see, these are what we may term as not so positive emotions, like boredom, pessimism, frustration, irritation, impatience, feeling overwhelmed, disappointed, doubt, worry. Then a number of things which I've not written here, things like anger, irritation, rage, jealousy, insecurity, frustration, etc. And lowest on the rung are fear, grief, depression, despair, and powerlessness. So whenever you find yourself in a feeling of depression or grief or fear, remember you are at the lowest rung of the emotional guidance system, and that is not the place to create what you want in your life. Okay? Because if you keep thinking that, that's what you will keep attracting to you. That's what will keep coming back to you. So that is why it is important for us to know the emotional guidance system, because it tells you where you are in terms of your particular vibrations. So if you want to feel good, as I said, do the exercise of getting into a state of feeling good, anchor, and then think of what you wish to have. Right? So right on top we had, so we had things like joy and appreciation and gratitude and love. And right at the end we have, yes, okay. Now, let me share with you the steps to the law of attraction. We spoke of being clear regarding your desire. Remember, I said be very clear on what you desire to be or do or have. Next, you have to give it attention, energy, or focus. So just having clarity of what you wish to have is not enough. You have to give it attention. You have to give it focus. You have to give it energy. Right? And you have to allow receiving it. We will look at these as we go forward. So clarity, we discuss this. Know what you desire. Focus on your desire, not on what you do not wish to desire. Tell the universe or God or life, whoever, right, of what you wish to have. So ask them, boss, mala first class pahije. Can I have first class in this particular year of my degree? Right? So you have to actually mention it with your thoughts, etc. Avoid using the words want and need. Right? If you're doing your thinking in English, then please avoid using the words want and need, because they signify lack. When I say I want money, I'm actually saying I lack money. When I say need money, I'm showing I'm desperate for money. So what is the kind of vibration I'm giving out? I'm giving out vibrations of lack and desperation. So avoid using those words. Instead, say I have money. I'm grateful for the money I have. Though the money will come in the future, we will be grateful for it right now. And operate from prosperity consciousness instead of lack consciousness. So, this was the first bit about being clear. Step two, give attention, energy, focus to your desires. How do you do that? Bring your desires and your emotions and feelings into play while thinking constantly of your desire. So give it good positive vibrations, positive emotions. Use affirmations. You all are aware of affirmations, right? For example, every day and in every way, I am feeling better and better and better, right? Or I attract prosperity to myself. Or I am happy, right? So use affirmations constantly. Use questions. Questions is another thing which not many people speak of when you are talking of using the law of attraction. But simple questions like, what would it take for me to receive a lot of money in the next few days? What would it take for the universe to give me a lot of joy in my life right now? So when you ask questions, you're setting the universe into motion to give you what you are asking for. Okay, so that's another important element. Next, use visualizations. All of you know visualizations. You sit in one place, close your eyes, imagine what you wish to have. Imagine you've already received it and feel happy about it. So how would you feel when you receive it? So imagine that, visualize that. Use prayer. I spoke of prayer earlier. I gave you examples of that. Create a vision board or journal or check. You know, so vision board is where you take, a chart paper and you stick pictures of the things you wish to have in your life, or you create a journal. So let me share with you very quickly my journal. So this is my journal of what I call visioning, okay? So abundance, being fit, okay? Having something like a nice bike, cars, travel, these are some of the things, you know? Being inspired by people, inspiring others, having good, happy relationships, traveling around the world, right? Seeing beautiful places, having good things, having adventures. So having motorbike doesn't necessarily mean I want a motorbike, but it's about having an adventure, right? So traveling around the world, having good things in life. Once again, it's about travel and a nice house and stuff like that, and so on and so forth. And visualize money, lots of money, yeah? So. Yeah. So, oops. So those are about?
Because without money, you can't achieve that.
Yes, of course.
Powerful meaning.
Yes. This is a visualization check. You know, so you just create a check. A regular check will also do, and you just write pay myself. And write the amount you want. You're giving that check to the universe, and you wait for it to manifest. So you just say, okay, I want 10 crore rupees. And you just see it every day if you can. So after creating it, remember, you have to give it attention, energy and focus. If you just write it and don't do anything about it, the law of attraction will forget it. So remember, very important step, give it attention, energy and focus. Gratitude. Gratitude is a very important element. I've given a talk on gratitude years ago in the Help Library. If you can go to the archives and have a look at it, great. So whatever we...
abundance flows towards you.
Absolutely. So even if we have just 100 rupees, for example, right now, most people will focus, I am only 100 rupees. Instead, if you can change that vibration to, wow, I have 100 rupees. I have at least 100. Can I be happy about it? Right? So being grateful for whatever you have. This morning when I woke up, I found a 2 rupee coin on my bed. Now, I know it's not come from magic. Maybe my wife dropped it, my daughter dropped it, or it fell from my own pant pocket. I don't know. But that's the first thing I saw in the morning when I woke up. I said, wow, I'm so happy, you know, to receive this. So that's important. Being grateful for either 1 rupee also or for crores of rupees and for everything you have in life. So gratitude is very important. Again, forgiveness. Forgiveness, very important. Forgive yourself. forgive others, seek forgiveness for yourself, and an important element of forgiveness is please forgive your parents. So even if your parents are not in the body right now, in simple terms, if they're still not alive, mentally forgive them, because most of the grudges we hold subconsciously are towards our parents. Think of it. Okay, when you forgive them, it becomes easier to forgive others and forgive yourself. So remember to forgive your parents. And what's the last bit? Yeah, gratitude again, thank in advance. So when you thank for something in advance, that's another way to give energy to what you wish to have. Now, receiving again is a very important step of the law of attraction. We said, be clear, give energy to what you desire, and finally, allow receiving. What does that mean? It simply means that very often we have doubts in our mind. How am I yes up karao, but will it happen? So I'm trying all this, I'm using this technique, I'm using that technique, but maybe it will not work for me. It may work for her, it may work for him, it may work for her, but what if it doesn't work for me? So you have to be in a state of receiving. So whatever doubts you have, disbeliefs you have, let that go. Allowing means the absence of negative vibration. Be receptive and positive. Feel how you would feel when the desire is manifested. So the way to do that is get into the feeling of how would you feel when that thing you wish has come true. Right? So in advance, you're feeling happy to have received what you wish to have. Right? And give gratitude for that. Yeah, have gratitude for that. Okay? And the law of attraction is based on being happy. So, be happy and joyous raises your vibration. If you remember, joy was right at the top in the emotional guidance system. Happiness and joy are the basis for the LOA to operate. And use the law of attraction to create the life you desire. Okay? So that was about the law of attraction. Any questions? Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.